Axl Rose is a quintessential bad boy simply because he's scary.
He's one guy who has a short temper that plays out in public a lot of the times and ends up in a police station.
You gonna be out soon?
I think so.
By the time he was 17, he had 4 minor offenses. He had been through an alcohol program. It almost seems that Axl Rose was destined to become a bad boy.
He was a bad boy who drove women wild.
Axl Rose is a god. Sexy clothes and his hair and his like voice and like his face and his skin was just like an angel. I mean, he was beautiful.
Scrawny and endlessly introspective and kind of simultaneously cocky. I mean, I've always found Axl unbelievably sexy, and I think he's fabulous.
You look at him and you go, how could that be attractive? Well, the fact is he's also talented, so it helps.
Either you like rock and roll guys or you don't. I mean, it's a taste thing.
How does a public menace like this find love? Enter the ingenue, Erin Everly, daughter of one of the Everly brothers.
Axl Rose was smitten with Erin Everly from the beginning. She was a model. She was gorgeous. She was also part of rock royalty, and he liked that. But from the beginning of the relationship, there were problems.
Axl Rose's appetite for self-destruction included binge drinking and heavy partying. His bad reputation was growing as fast as his ego.
Thanks to the lame-ass security, I'm going home.
Soon, Erin was looking for the door, but Axl played his trump card.
She's got a smile that it seems to me reminds me of childhood memories.
He did write the song Sweet Child of Mine for her, so despite the fact that there may have been violence in the marriage, she was still honored. She was still taken aback by the fact, oh, here's a love sonnet to me.
For women, there's a fantasy that this rock star's adoration or lust for you will be forever immortalized for all of the world to hear. Much better if it's a hit song.
Of course, Erin didn't stay charmed forever. By 1991, she was out of there.
The marriage between Axl Rose and Erin Everly basically is what you'd call a starter marriage.
After Erin and Axl broke up, he started dating Stephanie Seymour, and he hit the jackpot. She was not only a model, she was a Victoria's Secret model, the trophy of all trophies. But that relationship, too, was also very contentious.
Now, you might ask yourself, what's a woman like Stephanie Seymour, who was at the time very successful, top model, not a drug user herself, what does she see in a guy like that? And no one can answer that question except her.
I don't really know exactly what I'm doing.
But the truth is, a lot of women seem to find this guy very, very sexy.
Apparently, that only goes so far.
Stephanie Seymour left, you know. Axel's alone right now, so I guess he hasn't found a girl to put up with it.
I don't have anything.
But there's still hope.
Women love crazy guys, so let's face it. They're all looking for a project. You know, it's funny. Guys are looking for projects when it comes to cars, and women are looking for projects when it comes to men. And he seems like he needs a fair amount of fixing.